Well, I think we did it. So some of these are missing. Only took 2 minutes to do. Problems finishing it. Were some pieces stolen? I bet they were missing to begin with. Still, doesn't look like the most stable kind of jar. I kind of understand how it got broken. Maybe it's upside down. What else can we examine here? This? What's this? Blood? It's a little worm. A worm. But there's definitely a handprint here. Looks like someone tried to wipe it off. Mr. Wright, what if there are bloodstains left in the room? We should use our testing fluid. Check it out. I want to use the whole bottle. That's what I was going to do after looking around for everything. So, good transition. Yep, I knew there was going to be one here. Why am I getting a reaction here? There's no reason for the murderer to touch this spot if you fled out the door. Must be something significant. Hey, that's some pretty amazing stuff you got there, pal. What's this? It's called luminal testing fluid. Where'd you get your hand on that? Huh? I'd like to get some too. Yeah, you would, Gumshoe. I'll just borrow 50 bucks from the chief. Where'd you get this, Emma? That was by mail order. Well, I'd better jot this down on the floor plans. Yep. The fact Gumshoe's here with us too, that's awesome. He's getting some evidence too. We're helping each other out. Well, there's a whole handprint. I knew it. Someone's hand, right hand. What's the matter, detective? The locker. It's mine. It's yours. Please. You have to help me. When they come to take me away. Promise you'll testify that I couldn't hurt one arm or fly. You'll do that for me, won't you, pals? It's an important clue. Jot down the floor plans. I'm counting on you guys. Believe me, you can't trust the police. But you're a detective. And then finally. Oof. Look at all that blood. That seems like the actual true murder scene right there. Must have been a massive amount of blood here. I've never even seen so much before. I'm not a professional, but what's your opinion, detective? Pale blue blood. Maybe Detective Goodman wasn't actually an alien. He was an android. It's just Ethereum. Proves something that really happened in front of this locker. I'll make a note of it on the floor plans. Hey, if you didn't want my opinion, you shouldn't have asked. And I think that should be it. There wouldn't be anything else, right? Just handprints. So, like, whose is that then? Examine this one. No? Okay, how do you know? And that's about it. I'd say that was it, really. Yep, all she wrote. See you later. Okay. This one's a long. This is a long one. Presents. This. Shares the other one list. Okay, I'm gonna say the same thing again. So, what about this boy? Guess not. Let's go, let's move to police department entrance. And then move into criminal affairs. Oh, he's not here anymore? Oh, my goodness. Alright, present this. What's your ID number? Could you take a look at this? I'm sorry, sir. Really sorry. I have no idea what that is. Maybe you should ask Mr. Edgeworth. He's passing the buck, Mr. Wright. Takes a special kind of man to pass the buck to Edgeworth. I guess we're gonna talk with Edgeworth. She doesn't have an ID anymore. You back, Edgeworth? No? Alright. Let's see. Maybe you know. Yes? You said you wanted some hot tea, right? No, but thanks. You must have to brew the leaves online. God damn it. I knew it had a secret What about this? Does this look anything familiar to you? No? I wish we could just get on saying no I don't and then we can move on. Once is enough. Oh, what if? Hold on. What if that's Marshall's locker? Detention center. Line cool offices. Move to... Alright. Present... this. Sheriff's back. Oh my god. Yeah, okay. Floor plans. What is the floor plans? None of these salmon. Court record. Check. Two spots in the blood. Maybe we could talk to Gumshoe about that. Present floor plans. No. Allow me to say one thing. Speaking as a detective, I see a piece of evidence I know nothing about. I say nothing, nothing. You bet it's fine, pal. Alright, what about this? Can't open the lock, your fingerprints doesn't match. If you can open it, I'll give you 50 cents. The police department lacks faith in its lock system. After all, Detective Goodman was stabbed here after opening his locker. But at the same time, he was found dead over at the prosecutor's office. And they're 30 minutes away. See that fucking 30 minute, like, split? That's where I get, like, lost right now. I don't think there's anything else here. Unless you have something to talk about. No. Alright. There's gotta be something I missed. This. Wow, look at this big pile of junk in the corner. Looks like a car door. A pair of handcuffs attached to the frame. Maybe the guy they caught was some sort of escape artist. He got away. Yeah, that's one of those human profiles for range testing. He's been shot square in the forehead. Better him than us. What about this? Someone left a glove here, but only a one. Detective Gumshoe, maybe? Every time. There you go, pal, making me some kind of absent-minded detective. That's evidence from the case, you know. Even SL9, it doesn't have a tag on it. Oh, okay, that's what we missed. Anything else? This paint up here? No? What's this? They're stuffed with evidence. Stuffed with dreams. Not sure about the dreams. It won't open. Guess I should have known. Our security is high-tech around here, yep. Maybe I can go talk with Edrith now. Hopefully. One, two, three, and four. Fuck. He's not here still. Detective Goodman's note and the switchblade knife. But Edrith was the most surprised of anyone because of the SL9 connection. That was Mr. Edrith's first big case, you know, 2 years ago. That was the first time the world knew Edrith was a man to be feared. Why would evidence from the case turn up now? I guess it's not over, pal. Maybe there are some loose ends left on that case. Oh, here we go. Now that was a bloody, violent case. Violence. So it was a murder. Serial killing. Maybe I don't want to get involved in this after all. Claire made a mistake and Mr. Edgerth built his case around that to nab him. And this was 2 years ago. And that put Mr. Edgerth right in the spotlight and started the rumor mill. About forged evidence. It was supposed to be all cleaned up with the transfer the other day. The last job you ever did. Detective Goodman, that is. What do you mean? Detective Goodman was the detective in charge of the SL9 agency. So the switchblade knife. The victim took the knife out of the evidence locker himself. Hey, pal, look at the time. Was there something you needed to be going to? Just that Mr. Edwards, the inquiry committee, should be letting out soon. I'm going to give them my report for the day. What is that? I might help, you know. Report? You mean the note written on the back of the flyer? The one that says nothing but no problems? Hey, it's Mr. Edgeworth you're talking about. I'm sure he can report. He can report like this. I believe in him. Who needs enemies when you've got friends like Detective Gumshoe? Yeah, well, I'm off, pal, later. Alright, now we can talk with Edgeworth. I should probably see what Edgeworth has to say, too. Oh boy. We're only on the second day. Actually, tomorrow's the last day, right? Or, no. We're done the first. Right? We just finished the first court. So there's two more after this. Wrong place again. Oh my god. Oh god. Please. Let me out of here. Move. Edgeworth. Yes. Yes. Oh my. Yes. Not this guy again. Oh my god. Oh, it's you. Remember me? Have we met somewhere? Huh? Mr. Edgeworth, I beg you leave. Your leave so long. Is Edgeworth here? They're standing by the window. A teacup is in his hand. How do you not see him if he's standing by the window? Ah, that's you. He has the hotel bring him tea service. Mr. Edgeworth, you're back from the district prosecutor's office inquiry? Precisely. By the way, Detective Gumshoe was looking for you. Oh yes, he brought me some information, it seems. Really? Was it helpful? And apparently a new fresh French restaurant is opening near here. I think he was trying to console me somehow. I think the report is on the other side, Edgeworth. Poor Mr. Edgeworth, I think the whole thing is really taking a toll on him. So how did the inquiry committee go? Actually, they decided to treat this not as a case of concealing evidence, but as a communication error during the investigation. Yes, apparently there are some who believe that I concealed evidence. They gave me a warning. You were lucky this time, again. Again. I've heard them say that so many times, ever since that case 2 years ago. Are you okay for the trial tomorrow? Well, I'm still presiding, prosecuting attorney, however. Something happened. They gave control over the investigation over to the police department. Yes, and any further investigation for this case will be directed by the chief of police, Gant. I can't do nothing but wait for your results. Why I ask you why? All along I've done only what I believe is right. I'm nothing to be ashamed of. But still. I've never seen him out of sorts, you know. Edgeworth doesn't screw up. At least not as much as that, but not as, as much as he did. Alright, I'd better check this now. As I was saying, what's this? A record of ID card usage? Edgeworth, you went into the evidence room that day, didn't you? Just before the incident occurred, no less. Yeah, that's true. Why, Mr. Edgeworth? Please don't look at me like that. He didn't do it. Edgeworth didn't do it. I was asked to go by Chief Gant, no less. Chief of Police. He wanted evidence for a case that wrapped up half a year ago. Told me he wanted to keep it here, in the prosecutor's office. It was solved, right? If the evidence is already filed, Chief would never want to explain himself. In any case, on the day of the state of the stabbings, I brought this back here. Can I ask what kind of case it was? I can't say. It really has nothing to do with the current case. Now I'm curious about the other case. Better make a note of it. Stubborn as always, I told you that this has nothing to do with the current case. Yes, it does. Look. Right, please. I'm the prosecutor on this case. You don't expect me to sit here and discuss the case with you over a cup of tea. I'll pass on the tea. Just tell me about the case. Mr. Wright and Mr. Edward told you no in a very polite manner. Whose side are you on, anyway? Maybe if I just show him my best evidence, I could get some reaction out of him. What about... What about, this? No? I know you probably got a hold of some information already, right? And how it's to do with the case you were on, the SL9 incident. And some dark suspicion you're wrapped up in. You're the man who revived the worst memory of my life, as I recall. I figured I'd be telling you about this sooner or later. Yep, a bad memory. He's talking about the murder in the elevator. Okay, Edgeworth, why don't you tell me about it? Tell me the truth. SL9 incident was a heinous serial killing case. The head of investigation was the deputy chief of police at the time, Damon Gantz. Okay. That was a wacky old coot who was involved in a case 2 years ago too then. He was the best we had, and it was my first time working with him. I was nervous. Well, you get nervous too, Mr. Edgeworth. What I want to know is why the deputy chief of police on the investigation. In truth, I used slightly more extreme methods than normal. If we were dealing with a vicious murderer. If I let him go, then blood would be on my hands. We won our guilty verdict, and the killer was executed. You didn't. Of course not. I didn't touch the evidence. Yes, I will do anything in the power to win a trial. However, I do have a code and I follow it faithfully. By the way, Emma, the chief prosecutor wanted to know something. What? You still working on that scientific investigation? Yes, of course. Why, just today, Miss Wright and I were using this. Luminal testing fluid, hmm? Well then, you might have use for this. Ooh, more things! Fingerprints, yeah, nice. It's been chemically treated for the better adhesion. For me, are you sure? You're the enemy, you know. Have no say in today's investigation. Do as you will. Edward Thumberley. No need to thank me. Here, take your powder and these fingerprint files for everyone involved. Thanks. How about giving these to Detective Gumshoe as well? Nice. More things to use. Let's get going. One last investigation. Right. I do seem to remember seeing a suspicious handprint somewhere. It's time to walk all the way back there. Thank you, Edruth. Helpful as always. There's a lot more, willing to do things and help out. The fact that he gave us evidence or like things to help us with our case means his chances of winning the case and giving a guilty verdict are less, right? He would never do that if we were on the second case or the second trial. This one, yeah. Oh, what's his face? Marshall's not here. An investigation today. It turned out a suspicious handprint. Here in the blood on the detective's evidence locker. Let's use the secret weapon we just borrowed. I was gonna check the other one first, but why not? Let's get started. First, choose a finger. Each finger leaves behind a slightly different imprint. Let's choose the finger that will have left behind the clearest prints. I really can't tell the difference at a glance. Come on, Phoenix. Quit procrastinating and choose a finger. This one. Okay, now it's the time to check for preferred. Let's show you how it's done. Emma's starting to get that sparkle in her eyes. Well, first we sprinkle aluminum powder around. How do you do that? Just touch the screen. See? Ah, it looks like that did the trick. The aluminum powder adheres completely to the prints. One that the powder is well spread. Just blow with the excess. How do I do that? Just blow with your breath. Imagine you're blowing out the candles on the cake. See? Looks fun. It might take some getting used to though. It won't go up to your nose or anything. You just pour the powder on thick and blow away the extra. Those are the basics of the fingerprints, Mr. Wright. I guess I'd better give it a try. Uh-oh. I don't know. How do I blow? It just don't work. Uh-oh. I might be in a pickle. Hey, I did it. Here, wait, let's get more of that. Oof. Did it! We found one, but looks nothing like a fingerprint. Now that you mention it, I guess it doesn't. What does it mean? I think it means we're out of luck. Out of luck. The person who left this handprint must have worn gloves. Don't tell me you've been wasting your time here. Hey, calm down. That's just the way it goes sometimes with the scientific investigations. But it does seem a shame. While we're at it, why don't we look for other prints? Looking at the other door again closely, yeah. Leave. Seems there are fingerprints outside the bloody handprint as well. Let's see if we can find a clear print. Fingerprints outside of the blood. Like this? Oh no, here. Alright, spread the powder. It's everywhere. No, I missed a spot. Everywhere. It's gonna be a black, just a completely white screen. Don't miss a speck. Almost there. All right. I think we're good. Hold on. There's still some specks. Oh my god. All right. Ah, yeah, print's so clear, it's dazzling. Anyway, the print took a lot of effort to find. Let's match it up right away. We're not done yet, this is quite a process. Well, there's no point in finding your fingerprints. Not knowing who the owner is. Yeah, she's right. Look at the fingerprint data we got from Miss Edgeworth, and point out the person who think that left these prints. How am I supposed to know who it was? I could make a pretty good guess. The blood has handprint and the fingerprint are in different places, right? That means the finger probably don't have anything to do with our case. So whose fingerprint would we most likely find on the evidence locker? Yep. Complete. Match found. I knew it was Gumshoe the whole time. So these prints belong to Detective Gumshoe. I love how he's angry in the picture. Something wrong, Mr. Wright. You gave me this so what look. I guess that's probably because I was thinking so what. Okay, so we came up with nothing this time, but there's always a nice time. Sometimes you hit, sometimes you miss. You gotta roll with the punches, Mr. Wright. Thanks for the sympathy. Wait, if I remember correctly, there was one other handprint in this room. Let's check it out. I was gonna check that first. We wouldn't have gone through all that. All that mumbo jumbo. There it is. Check. No. Maybe examine. This one. We got a luminous fluid reaction, right? Right. There was a handprint here. Okay, wanna try eating this? Yeah. Check for prints. A spirit. Oh, but I have to warn you about something first. What? The area with blood was wiped away, right? We only ended up finding it using chemical means. Any prints in that area will have to be wiped away too. Right. That means no prints. What would you say the probability to have feathers is high? Don't ask me. Anyway, we must try to find prints that weren't wiped away. Prints other than the ones left by the bloody hand. Which one? This one, maybe? Wee. That should be good, right? Perfect. Nope. Perfect. That's like the text for brain age. Hey, these fingerprints, the font. Oh, whose are they? Whose? Is it someone I know? It's Officer Marshall. Officer Jake Marshall. There we go, now he has to talk. That's gotta be a coincidence. He's not involved in the crime. Emma. This is decidedly different from Detective Gumshoe's prints. The luminal reaction, the blood and the fingerprints are in the same place. So we have Jake Marshall's fingerprints. Only on a white blood stain. Why would Officer Marshall? Looks like your investigation finally turning up some results. I guess this is what you'd call decisive evidence. I don't believe it. Why don't you believe it?